1, 2, 3, 4.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour. This is episode 16. I'm your host, Dan Krotz. We've had two big events since we last got together. One, of course, has been our rain, and the other is a successful farm-to-table celebration that we'll spend a little bit of time describing and talking about as our program unfolds today. The rain, of course, is one of those tender mercies that was long anticipated because of the nearly 2 months of drought that we experienced. I have to say it's been such a pleasure all week driving about the county and looking at the fields turn green again, and the cattle looking much more contented, and the stock ponds filling up, all of that. The rain reminds me of an old poem that I used to recite to girlfriends trying to impress them. I was never very successful at that, but I stood out in the rain one morning at about 5:30 and let it just run down my body and get my hair damp and dripping. It was just wonderful. And I recalled the poem, and I can't remember if it was by E.E. Cummings or William Carlos Williams, but the first stanza went something like this. Somewhere I have never traveled gladly beyond any experience, your eyes have their silence. In your most frail gesture are things which enclose me, or which I cannot touch because they are too near. And then the second stanza goes something like this. I do not know what it is about you that closes and opens. Only something in me understands the voice of your eyes is deeper than all roses. Nobody, not even the rain, has such small hands. I love that poem. Really makes me wonder why I wasn't more successful in getting a girlfriend back in the old days. You'd think a poem like that would just grab someone's heart and allow her to open it up to some boy, some would-be man, no matter how unreliable or unattractive you might appear. But I guess poetry will not always win a heart. Nevertheless, every time it rains, I think of that poem, and this week with the rain coming down, I have been thinking about it a lot, and I am so grateful for the weather we've been having lately. I said we had two big events. The other event was a very successful farm-to-table celebration that Carroll County Fresh sponsored. Let me tell you a little bit about Carroll County Fresh. I think we have been remiss in doing that in some of our previous episodes. But let me say that Carroll County Fresh is a sustainable agricultural initiative that aims to give the residents of Carroll County access to fresh, affordable, high-quality, locally grown food and food products. What Carroll County Fresh holds in common are the holistic goals of sustainable agriculture. And here's a definition of sustainable agriculture. It means to integrate environmental health, boost economic profits for farmers, and promote social and economic equity. Carroll County's Fresh's aim is to support small-scale producers, farmers market vendors, and value-added processors by providing access to resources and technical assistance. So when you go to farmers markets, you are supporting Carroll County Fresh, and Carroll County Fresh in turn supports those farmers markets vendors through a variety of initiatives. For example, we facilitate partnerships and collaborations to sustain local agriculture and increase family farm incomes. And our members are growers and producers who sell a wide range of organic and naturally grown products, including vegetables, fruits, plants, meat, and poultry. One of the things that it's important to know about Carroll County Fresh is that we consider the impact of our plans and practices not only on our local farms, environment, and community, but also on communities and environments worldwide. Part of my life prior to retirement involved traveling around the world, for example, to Malawi, Africa, Tunisia, Kosovo after the war, to Laos, Vietnam, and places like that, really to see what kinds of agriculture is going on, what kinds of appropriate technologies were employed, and banking those memories and those experiences to see what could be translated into our farms and communities here in the Ozarks. Carroll County Fresh believes that sustainability depends on meeting the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. So that's probably more than you wanted to know about Carroll County Fresh, but let me tell you that it is a membership organization, and we encourage you to get involved. We have monthly board meetings. Anyone from the community is invited to attend those meetings, and we hope you will. Contact us at our website, carrollcountyfresh.org, and leave us an email and let us know how we can get a hold of you, and then we'll begin the conversation with one another. Let me also say that part of what Carroll County Fresh does is to support local businesses of all kinds, small businesses of all kinds. And we're big promoters of local culture, the arts, and artists. We believe that everything that we need is right here. So if you are an artist, a writer, a novelist, an editorial writer, a potter, give us an email at carrollcountyfresh.org. And we will be delighted to find out more about what you do and interview you and help you publicize your good works to our friends and neighbors throughout Carroll County and the Ozarks. Let me also say that if you are a musician, we would love to record your music and play it here on the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour. Again, just contact us at carrollcountyfresh.org, and we will record and play your music and interview you and let folks know all about your thinking, your background, and your musical frames of reference. So, anyways, that's the commercial for the program. We'll now go and listen to an interesting bit of stuff about what goes on. One of the things One of the things that we described as we opened up the program was the farm-to-table celebration and what a success it was. We're going to hear some interviews of people who were at the dinner. It's a noisy, joyous time, and you'll be glad to hear what they have to say about this celebration, and it will make you sorry that you missed it if you did. We will also have an interview with the Crescent Hotel's executive chef and food and beverage manager, Michael Jasckey. It was a fun and very interesting interview because Michael obviously loves food, loves preparing it, and loves seeing the faces and expression of his customers as they enjoy their dinners and lunches at the Crescent Hotel's dining room. And then late in the show, as we close out the show, it will be an interview with Paul O'Neill of Kings River Fine Arts. Paul O'Neill is a wonderful plein air painter. He is part of the Eureka Springs arts community for many years and is now a nationally successful and quite well-known artist. And we'll be talking with him to close out the program. Up next, a skit on seasonal eating by that fine actress, Mary Hayat, who is good enough to join John Heartbreak and talking about seasonal eating.
Psst! Hey, you! Little girl! Come here!
Excuse me? Come here? In what world would I, an intelligent, fully evolved woman of the world, respond to "come here" from a vile little man wearing a gold neck chain?
Hey! No offense, Dolly! I'm a legit guy! Here, take my card!
Salmonella. National spokesman for synthetically produced vegetable matter. Spavin. What in the world is synthetically produced vegetable matter?
What's synthetically produced vegetable matter? Young lady, spavin is all of them great greens and reds and yellow colored triangle thingies piled up in the produce aisles. They're perfect. Round is round, and tubes are fantastically tubular. They're great!
Are you talking about tomatoes and zucchini? They won't be at our farmers' markets for at least another week. Maybe 10 days. No thank you, Mr. Manila. I believe in seasonal eating, so I'll wait a little bit.
Wait? Are you nuts? Spavin means you can have what you want when you want it. Wait! Waiting is for losers, little girl.
Pardon me, but I've learned that good things come to those who wait. If I simply and mindlessly bought spavin instead of eating seasonally, I would miss the feeling of anticipation for next week's Arkansas Traveler tomatoes, the desire and the longing for local melons and apples. Love, Mr. Manella. Real love always involves waiting and hoping. So no thanks to your synthetically produced vegetable matter. I want the real thing. I want fresh, local, and truthful food.
Oh, you're a rotten kid.
No, Mr. Manila, I'm a healthy, radiant, attractive, and fully alive young woman because I eat real food produced by my friends and neighbors. So no spavin for me.